Good morning, Yale. I hope all of you are doing well, and I hope to see you all very soon. Please be safe and take care. So today we're going to continue, and we're going to do lesson 12. Watch me. Tell me if I hold up all of my fingers, or some of my fingers, or none of my fingers. Is this all of my fingers, or some of my fingers, or none of my fingers? Get ready. Yes, all of my fingers. Is this all of my fingers, or some of my fingers, or none of my fingers? Get ready. Yes, none of my fingers. Is this all of my fingers, or some of my fingers, or none of my fingers? Get ready. Yes, some of my fingers. Now it's your turn. Everybody, hold up none of your fingers. Get ready. What are you holding up? Get ready. Right, none of my fingers. Say the whole thing. Get ready. Right, I am holding up none of my fingers. Everybody, hold up all of your fingers. Get ready. What are you holding up? Get ready. Right, all of my fingers. Say the whole thing. Get ready. Right, I am holding up all of my fingers. Let's try another game. I'm going to do something. See if you can figure out what I'm going to do. Listen, I'm going to stamp my foot, or stamp my feet, or stand up. What am I going to do? Get ready. Yes, I'm going to stamp my foot, or stamp my feet, or stand up. Am I going to stand up? Get ready. Yes, maybe. Am I going to stamp my feet? Get ready. Right, maybe. Am I going to stamp my foot? Get ready. Right, maybe. Am I going to sing? Get ready. Right, no. I'm going to stamp my foot, or stamp my feet, or stand up. What am I going to do? Get ready. Right. Stamp your foot, or stamp your feet, or stand up. Here I go. Did I stand up? Get ready. Right, no. Did I stamp my feet? Get ready. Right, yes. Did I sit down? Get ready. Right, no. What did I do? Get ready. Yes, stamp your feet. Say the whole thing. Get ready. Right, you stamped your feet. I'm going to name some objects. Tell me a class these objects are in. Listen, spaghetti, beans, ice cream, salad. Everybody, what class? Get ready. Yes, food. Listen, school, garage, house, restaurant. Everybody, what class? Get ready. Yes, buildings. Listen, axe, hoe, hammer, screwdriver, shovel. Everybody, what class? Get ready. Yes, tools. I'm going to name a class. See how many objects you can name in that class. Listen, food. Yes, very good. Ice cream is food. A hot dog is food. A burger is food. And spaghetti is food. Very good. Good job. I'm going to name another class. See how many objects you can name in that class. Listen, buildings. Get ready. Very good. Yes, a restaurant is a building, and a house and a school is a building. I'm going to name another class. See how many objects you can name in that class. Listen, tools. Get ready. Yes, a hammer is a tool. A screwdriver is a tool. And a shovel is a tool. Very good. Good job. I'm going to say statements. Some of these statements tell where the bicycle is. Some of these statements don't tell where the bicycle is. Listen, the bicycle is in the street. Say the statement. Get ready. Does that statement tell where the bicycle is? Get ready. Where is the bicycle? Get ready. Yes, in the street. Listen, the bicycle is wet. Say the statement. Get ready. Does that statement tell where the bicycle is? Get ready. Right. No. Now it's your turn to make up statements. Make up a statement that tells where the bicycle is. The bicycle is in the garage. Very good. That statement tells where the bicycle is. Now make up a statement that does not tell where the bicycle is. The bicycle is blue. Very good. That statement does not tell where the bicycle is. We're going to play a word game. Listen, I'm thinking about trees that are not wet. They're not wet. So what else do you know about them? Get ready. Yes, they're dry. Listen, I'm thinking of a rabbit that is fat. It's fat. So what else do you know about it? Get ready. Yes, it's not skinny. Listen, I'm thinking of a woman who is not old. She's not old. So what else do you know about her? Get ready. Yes, she's young. Listen, I'm thinking about a log that is long. It's long. So what else do you know about it? Get ready. Yes, it's not short. Everybody, how many days are in a week? Get ready. Yes, seven. say the fact, get ready. Everybody say the days of the week, get ready. Right. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. How many months are in a year? Get ready. Right. 12. Say the fact. Get ready. Right. There are 12 months in a year. Name the months of the year through December. Get ready. Right. January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. Everybody, how many seasons are in a year? Get ready. Right, 4. Say the seasons of the year. Get ready. Right, winter, spring, summer, fall. We're going to talk about how things are the same and how they are different. Listen, a chair and a table. See if you can name 2 ways they are the same. Very good. A chair and a table are furniture, and a chair and a table could be made of wood. You told me how a chair and a table are. Get ready. Yes, the same. Listen, a chair and a table. See if you can name 2 ways they are different. Get ready. Yes, you could sit on a chair, but you cannot sit on a table. So you told me how a chair and a table are. Get ready. Yes, different. Here's another one. Listen, ice cream and snow. See if you can name 2 ways they are the same. Get ready. Yes, ice cream and snow are cold, and you can touch ice cream and snow. So you told me how ice cream and snow are. Get ready. Yes, the same. Listen, ice cream and snow. See if you can name 2 ways they are different. Get ready. Yes, you could eat ice cream, but you cannot eat snow. And yes, ice cream could be made of different colors, but snow cannot. Snow is just white. So you told me how ice cream and snow are. Get ready. Yes, different. First, you'll tell me about the days of the week. Then you'll tell me about the date. Tell me the day of the week it was yesterday. So today is Friday. What day of the week was it yesterday? Get ready. Yes, Thursday. tell me the day of the week it is today. Get ready. Yes, Friday. No dates. Everybody tell me yesterday's date. Get ready. Right, yesterday's date was Thursday, April 2nd, 2020. Tell me today's date. Get ready. Right, today's date is Friday, April 3rd, 2020. Very good. Everybody, I'm going to read you a story. Listen to the things that happened in the story because you're going to have to fix up a picture that shows part of the story. This is a story about some rats. Listen. A bunch of rats lived near a pond that was on a farm. The rats got along well, except for two of them. The other rats called these two the bragging rats because they were always bragging, quarreling, and arguing about something. One day they argue about who could eat the most. Another day they scrabble and quarrel over who was the best looking. Neither of them was very good looking. One was a big gray rat with the longest tail you had ever seen on a rat. The other one wasn't big, but he had the biggest yellow teeth you had ever saw. Listen to the last part again and get a picture in your mind about those rats. One was a big gray rat with the longest tail you had ever seen on a rat. The other one wasn't big, but he had the biggest yellow teeth you had ever saw. What was unusual about the big gray rat? Right, it had the longest tail you had ever seen on a rat. What was unusual about the other rat? Right, it had the biggest yellow teeth you had ever saw. What are some of the things these two would argue about? Yes, they would argue about who was the best looking and who could eat the most. The other rats in the bunch didn't pay much attention to the bragging and quarreling until the two rats started bragging about who was the fastest rat in the whole bunch. This quarrel went on for days, and the other rats got pretty sick of listening to the rats shout and yell and brag about how fast they were. Listen, what were the two bragging rats arguing about? Right, they were arguing about who was the fastest rat. On the third day of their quarrel, they almost got into a fight. The rat with the yellow teeth was saying, "I'm so fast that I could run circles around you while you run as fast as you could." The big rat said, "Oh yeah? Well, I could run circles around your circles. That's how fast I am." Are these rats kind of silly? Yes, they're silly, right? Because they're arguing for no reason. The two rats continued yelling at each other until a wise old rat said, "Stop! We are tired of listening to all this shouting and yelling and bragging. There is a way to find out who is the fastest rat on this farm." How could they find out who was the fastest? Yes, they could have a race. The wise old rat continued, "We will have a race for any rat that wants to race. Everybody will line up, run down the path to the pond, then run back. The first rat to get back is the winner. And Then we'll have no more arguing about which rat is the fastest. Get a picture in your mind of how they're going to run. They'll start at the starting line, run down the path to the pond, turn around at the pond, and run all the way back to the starting line. The wise old rat said, there will be no more arguing about who could run the fastest. Why wouldn't there be any more arguing about which rat was the fastest? Yes, because the race would prove who was the fastest. The rats agreed, and early the next morning, they were lined up ready for the big race. Six rats entered the race. The bragging rats were lined up right next to each other, making mean faces and mumbling about how fast they were going to run. The rats put on their nose close to the ground, ready to take off like a flash. Everybody steady, the wise old rat said. Everybody ready? Go! The rats took off toward the pond. The big gray rat got ahead of the others with the yellow toothed rat right behind him. But just before they got to the pond, the yellow toothed rat stepped on the long tail of the gray rat, and both rats tumbled over and over in a cloud of dust. Listen, why did the two rats start tumbling? Yes, because the yellow toothed rat stepped on the long tail of the gray rat. Where were they when this accident took place? Yes, almost to the pond. I wonder if something bad is going to happen. Let's see. The two bragging rats tumbled down the dusty path and right into the pond. The other rats finished the race. The winner was a little black rat. It was hard for her to finish the race because she was laughing so hard over the bragging rats who were still splashing and sputtering around in the pond. After the race, all the other rats went back to the pond. The bragging rats were still splashing and sputtering. The wise old rat said to them, "So now we know who the fastest runner on this farm is. It's neither of you. So we'll have no more arguments from either of you about who could run the fastest. Listen. Who won the race?" "Yes, a little black rat." "Do you think the bragging rats will stop arguing about who is the fastest?" "You think so or no?" "No? Okay, we'll see." The bragging rats looked at each other. The rat with the yellow teeth suddenly smiled and said, "I may not be the fastest runner in this bunch, but there is no rat in this world who can swim as fast as I can." "Oh yeah," said the gray rat. "I could swim so fast that I could go all the way across the pond without even getting my fur wet." The wise old rat and the other rats just walked away from the pond, slowly shaking their heads. Why do you think they were shaking their heads? Right, because the race didn't settle anything. I don't think these bragging rats will ever stop bragging and arguing. Everybody, open your workbook to lesson 12. Write your name at the top of the page. This picture shows something that happened in the story. Where are the bragging rats? Yes, in the pond. Everybody, do those rats look very happy? Get ready. Right, no. Is the race still going on when this picture takes place? Get ready. Right, no. How do you know the race is over? Right, because all the other rats are laughing and the bragging rats are in the pond. See if you could find the rat that ended up winning the race. Remember, that's a little black rat. See if you could find the wise old rat. That's the oldest looking rat in the picture. Everybody, take out a yellow crayon and a gray crayon. Listen, put a little mark on the teeth of the rat that had yellow teeth, then put a gray mark On the other bragging rat, either you could color this picture. Everybody find the next page in your workbook or your worksheet. Your page should look just like mine. Not hard to see, but you should see it right there. Sorry, guys. There you go. So we're going to start with this one and then we'll go to this one. Find the flower. Here's a coloring rule for the flower. Listen, color the petals red. What's the rule? Get ready. Yes, color the petals red. Mark the petals. Here's another coloring rule for the flower. Listen, color the roots brown. What's the rule? Get ready. Yes, color the roots brown. Mark the roots. Here's another coloring rule for the flower. Listen, color the leaves green. What's the rule? Get ready. Yes, color the leaves green. Mark the leaves. Part of the flower is missing. What part is missing? Get ready. Yes, the stem. Before you color the flower, you're going to follow the dots and make the stem. Listen, color the stem orange. What's the rule? Get ready. Mark the stem. Everybody, what place do you see in this picture? Get ready. Yes, an airport. Here's a coloring rule for this picture. Listen, color all vehicles yellow. What's the rule? Get ready. So put a yellow mark on one vehicle. Here's another coloring rule. Listen, color all buildings green. What's the rule? Get ready. Yes, color all buildings green. So put a green mark on one building. There's one more thing to do. One vehicle has a missing part. What vehicle is that? Get ready. Yes, one of the airplanes. What part of the airplane is missing? Get ready. Yes, a wing. Before you color the airplane, follow the dots and make a wing. Remember, the marks show you what color to make the vehicles and the buildings. You can color the other objects any color you want. And here's our coloring chart, just in case you need to remember. And that's the end of lesson 12. Thank you.